गुड इवनिंग एवरीबॉडी, वेलकम टू माय चैनल द इनविजिबल ट्रेडर। वीडियोस अगर आपको अच्छे लगते हैं तो लाइक कमेंट शेयर कीजिए और बाकी लोगों को हमारे साथ जोड़िए। ये हम जो वीडियो बना रहे हैं, दिस वीडियो इज आवर स्ट्रेट डाई वीडियो की सीरीज है एंड दिस इज बेस्ड ऑन ऑप्शन बाय। ओके, देयर लॉट ऑफ वीडियोस दैट यू विल सी इन द यूट्यूब व्हिच टॉक्स अबाउट ऑप्शन सेलर एंड दे आर ट्रू बिकॉज ए लॉट ऑफ स्ट्रेटजीज दैट यू सी राइट 95% more than 95% strategies are actually for option selling. I have never seen any strategies made for option buying except one or two that you might find in YouTube, which is ideally straddle, do a long one and identify the right strike price at the right premiums. I mean, same premium kind of stuff, leave it up to 3 o'clock, and there are many things, right? But ultimately, people know that option buying doesn't give you money, right? But there are a lot of people who makes money in option buying too, right? And as a retail trader, since you will have a very less capital, right? Most of the retail traders generally do option buying ideally, right? But ultimately, they lose in making money in option buying. And the reason is option buying, you cannot make money. First of the things, I'll straight come to the points. So today we will just do two things on option buying. We'll talk about first in option buying. The title is Guru Mantra. It's not like exactly a Guru Mantra, but some mantra is nothing but some rules. Okay. And if you play by rules, then actually your trading would be successful. And in option buying, rules are very, very important. When I'll complete the video and you go through the entire video, you will know that what are the rules I'm talking about and why they are important. So we'll talk about both in equity and index. These are the two things we will cover. Okay, if you are an option buyer, I would never recommend to you to do in forex or commodity. Okay, commodity and forex, etc., as a big no if you are an option buyer. Equity and index you can do. Equity maybe we have rules. I'll tell you why I do not prefer option buying and in what scenarios you need to do option buying. Okay, index may yes, because I make a lot of money on option buying in index, and index may you can make money in options buying. Equity may very, very rare. I'll tell you the reason why it is rare. Okay, so the reason, we'll start with equity, then we'll go to index. So when we're talking about equity, right, that means stocks. So the rules that we are going to follow in equity is ideally first rule is to never buy options in equity. I do not prefer option buying in equity. Okay, and even if you have small money, if you want to just do one lot selling and all those, do option selling. And I'll also tell you how you should do option selling in equity. Okay, so I personally never buy options, never unless it is intraday. Never means not positional. Intraday you still can do. Okay, intraday we still can do, but we need to do it only for equity stocks which are basically liquid in nature. Okay, liquid in nature means a lot of people are participating in the derivative segment of that equity. Okay, or stock like HDFC Bank, Kotak Bank, Reliance, right, Bajaj Finance, okay, and all those stuff. So if you see, you should always do option buying only in the top 10 to 15 stocks. Okay, top 10 to 15 stocks only in NSE. Okay, I would not tell anybody else to do anywhere else if you're an option buyer, right? The second thing is, if you are doing the option buying, cut your positions in intraday. Okay, cut your positions in intraday. I know there are a lot of people say that we may miss a big up move and a trending move, but those things very rarely happen, especially in index. Equity may you still can, but the only thing is that equity may, for example, let us say I take an example of okay, this is global market, sorry. So equity में if we say अने one day time frame में लेता हूँ, ठीक है? Now let's say if you have bought PE in SDFC bank here, right? First of all, you need to identify almost approximated right top and bottom, then only you can buy. And you have a, you should have a very, very strong view, okay? Market will move in your direction significantly, okay? Significantly. देखो ये जो fall हुआ है ना, this fall, if you would not have got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 days fall in HDFC bank, then you might not have made money in HDFC bank anyway. For example, let's say after 3 days, you got this green candle, let's say on the fourth day here, and let's say it is coming up to here, then you will not make money in option buying anyway. Okay, so it is very, very rare that you get a very continuous direction in stocks unless the stocks is being operated by operators or there is a news or it is making upper circuit and upper circuit every day, which is not possible in the top 50, the top 15 stocks. The rule that I have given you, right? The rule that I have given you, it will not be possible in the top 15. Okay, so the mantra here is ideally always do. If you want to do stock option, always do in 10-15 stocks, okay, and do intraday only. Never carry your positions in options stocks, okay, because the next day if market just stays at the same level or even a little bit below the level, then also you will not make money, okay, because stock option may the erosion is very, very high, the premium erosion is very, very high. Index may it's not, because there are a lot of supply demand game there. Okay, now these are the two rules that you need to follow if you are an option buyer. Okay, I'll not give you a lot of rules like 100 or 50 rules. I'll just talk about psychology, few rules which you can use to make money. Okay, so first of all, I would not prefer to buy options anyway in stocks. Even if I do, it is only intraday. Never take it to the next day ideally. Okay, unless you are very sure that market will come back to your level. Okay, for that you need to identify the proper support resistance levels, and you are confident that the market will come back to your level, right? Otherwise it is very, very difficult. There are very few people who actually take the, let's say for option buying, maine stocks mein kiya, HDFC mein kiya. For example, yahan pe maine C buy kiya, ye green candle pe, right? And next day market actually came down. Okay, so there are a lot of people who still take a risk. I have seen people, some of my friends, they do. Okay, and market came back here, right? So they will cut, they will wait just to cut their profit with almost cost to cost level, and no profit, no loss kind of trade. Okay, I personally do not prefer that. Okay, I personally do not prefer that. However, you can do that. But that is a risky game, okay? That is a risky game, and that is based on your conviction. If you have conviction, you can still take it for the next day. But I would recommend you not to take it for more than 2 days, okay? So I hope you remembered this. So I'll delete this. The actual trading in option, stock option, if you tell me, right? I generally do breakout tradings. Okay, I take very few stock options. Okay. Breakouts, okay, is generally breakouts. I would look for breakouts. How to identify breakouts? There are many YouTube videos that you might get, like a W pattern breakout, M pattern breakout, let's say triangle breakout with volume breakout supported by volume, right? Whatever it is, there are different kind of breakout theories which you can identify in your stocks, right? Always trade breakouts. Okay, always trade only breakout. So there are different scanners that you can make. I have made one scanner which I have said in the group, where you can see the breakouts for the next day, right? There are potential breakouts that you can identify based on the rules. One of the stocks, if you remember, that I have given, and those are like 100% confident trades. I generally very rarely give stocks in my channel, but I, especially positional, right? But when I give, the stocks never fail, which I give ideally, right? Because it takes a lot of parameters into picture, and out of 2-3 2500 stocks, it just identifies one or two stocks. Okay. And if you can identify one or two stocks on a weekly basis, one stock in a week. Okay. So if you can just identify one stock in a week, we are good. Okay. And we will get definitely one stock in a week, which is doing some kind of breakout, upside or downside. Okay. And here we are not doing option buying. We are doing option selling. Okay. Because I generally do not have time to monitor this. So I prefer to do option selling, even if it is just one lot. Guys, what I'm telling you, if you follow these rules, okay, or mantras, whatever we say it, on a longer term, believe me, you will make money. Okay. Otherwise, you will spend 3 years, 4 years in the share market. Ultimately, your account will be red only. Okay. So even if it is small money, the power of small money is very huge when they get added. A lot of people talk about the power of compounding. In stock market, I also talk about the power of addition. Okay. People who have felt it, they only can understand this statement. Okay. Otherwise, people who are watching these videos for the first time, listening to these words for the first time, they will never understand unless they go through that phase. Okay. So anyway, whoever is watching, I'm just telling you how to do things with rules, right? So for example, this is a breakout ideally. You see this breakout, okay? Where I trade, I do not trade here. I trade when the candle is closed here. What we will do? We would basically sell the PE. You can sell this kind of PE actually. When the breakout happened, would have sell 1530 ka PE or 1550 ka PE, okay? Yeah. 1500, let's say I have sold 1550p, which is at this level. Okay. I have sold 1550p. The next day market came down below that level. It came down below that level. Next day it went up, but assume that it didn't even went up. It's just consolidated here. Even if it does that, then also you are going to make money. Then also you are going to make money. Let's say after 3-4 days of consolidation, market is heavily coming down. Then also you are going to make money. That money would be less, but the profit would be less, but you will make money. So that is the power of option selling. And you can do naked selling in breakouts. I generally do. Okay. I generally do naked selling in breakout, very one or two stocks, not more than that. In a month. I do one or two stocks. Okay. Selling. Always do breakouts, and in the breakouts, always do option selling, whatever the small amount it is. Okay. That is the rule. Okay. Now, if it is doing a breakout on the upside, sell P. If it is doing a breakdown on the downside, sell C. As simple as that. Okay. So most of the time, 60 to 70% of the time, market will anyway would be on an upper trend. Okay. Only 30 to 40% of the time, market generally goes in a downtrend. So if you look at from here to here, if you minus this area, if you minus this, not even this. If you minus this area, only these 4-5 candles, if you have blindly sorted PE, right, blindly sorted PE at this level continuously for the entire month, then also you could have made money very easily. Okay. That is the power of selling PE ideally. Okay. Selling CE ideally doesn't work most of the time. I am more comfortable in selling PEs. Selling CE works, but it's like, as I said, 30% of the time. 70% of the time selling PE will work. But anyway, irrespective of that, that is just a tip. Irrespective of that, always trade on the breakout. Okay. So for example, there is a breakdown happening on the downside. For example, this level, right? And the breakdown is happening this side. So this is the breakdown. You have to identify breakouts and breakdowns, of course. Once you have identified this breakdown, you sell C. Okay. Even if it consolidates below the breakdown level, then also you are going to make money. As simple as that. Okay. So stocks, my guys, we are talking a lot of things, but the thing that you guys need to remember, whatever the things that I'm writing here as a rule or a mantra, okay? I hope people are noting it down. So here in equity, there are only two mantras that I have given. In the first, as I said, that always do intraday, okay? If you are doing option buying, okay? I gave two rules. Now, one is option buying. This one I'm telling for option selling, okay? So now this is equity, nothing more than this. Just do your option trading just based on these two rules. When you want to do buy, when you want to do sell, as simple as that. Okay. Now let's come back to the the complex stuff, which is ideally we call index, okay, option ka index. Okay, now see guys, index mein, as I said, option buying mein you can make better money, more money ideally, and a more comfortable money compared to equity. Okay, so if you're an option buyer, do it more in index compared to equity, because equity mein there are very very low probable chances of making money in option buying if you're keeping the position for a longer term. Okay, and here the rule is, guys, okay, and this rule is ideally applicable to even option selling. So if you're an intraday option buyer, okay, and why I'm saying buyer, even seller, and if it is naked position, okay, seller means naked position, a lot of option seller go with hedging position, options buyer are mostly naked option buyers. Okay, so if you're an intraday naked option buyer or an intraday naked option seller, intraday buyer, then you have to be a very good scalper. Okay, very good scalper. How, what is the, I hope everybody understands what is the meaning of scalping. But aap agar scalping karna chahte ho, then how you want to do scalping? There is a video already that I have made. So if you go to my channel content, there would be something. Yeah. Episode 08, intraday scalping magic, right? Rules, tips and tricks. It's an 1 hour video almost, but here I have explained you in detail how you need to do scalping and you can become a good scalper. Remember that, guy, people, and this is also a mantra rule, people who are not doing scalping on an intraday basis, especially in option buying, I can give you in writing, they will never make money profitably over every day. You see my trades every day. I used to sew my PNL. Now I have stopped it for a month. But if you look at, I make money. And most of the time, if you look at, I do scalping, right? So as an option buyer, you 70 to 80% of the time, you have to do buying only, scalping only. Okay. So there are 20%, 25% of the time when you have a very strong belief of that market will go in your direction. Just say we did it during the budget wala stuff, right? So people who have kept it might have kept it for 2-3 days because you know the direction is on the upside. So you might have played it long, okay, event based. Otherwise, if you are not an, okay, I'll just, this is not visible. Okay, so if you're an option buyer and especially intraday, remember that you have to be a very good scalper. Okay, if you're not doing scalping, if somebody is telling them, somebody that I am an option buyer and I do positional option buying, I am telling you, I'll give it in writing, they have never made money profitably over every day, year over year. You cannot make it. That's not possible ideally. Okay, option selling is still possible, option buying is not. Okay, the video is already there. I have shown you episode 08. Go and look that how to become a good scalper and what are the rules, tips, tricks to scalp it. Okay, so basically scalping has to be on levels. So if you are so confident, if you watch the video of scalping, there I have explained you, how do you know from where market will give a reaction? Okay, whether it is a reversal reaction, whether it is a retracement reaction, whatever, there are different methodologies. Okay, that's what I have put it in my channel. And that is why I said that I will make a video on this. There are different methodologies, different setups. Everybody has their own setups. Okay, there are few setups that we have discussed in our group also. There are few setups in YouTube also, which will tell you that you do option buying, depending on considering VWAP, RSI, open interest and all those stuff. And believe me, guys, every setup works, but they don't work 100% of the time. Okay. And since you are doing option buying with a setup, irrespective of how strong is your setup, if you are not doing scalping 60 to 70% of the time, you cannot make money. Okay, as simple as that. I'll tell you, scalping, you have to see the video. Okay, now when I say it, that when I trade in option buying, I always tell that it is not the price which I trade. I always trade the time. Okay. Because in option buying, timing is very, very important. I'll give you an example. Okay. What do you mean by time? Okay. Now let's say, and we are talking about index, guys. Okay. This doesn't apply to stocks. Now look at, take a 5 minute time frame chart of Bank Nifty and Nifty both. I'll explain you when Bank Nifty, it is more volatile. Nifty method, it will work more wonderfully actually. If you see any bull run in Nifty, even if how much a big bull run it is from here to here, almost 1,000 points ka bull run. If you look at here, Bank Nifty did it in how many candles? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. After that, there is a significant fall. There is a significant fall, and then in this bull run also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then a significant fall. In this fall also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then market moves up. If you see this pattern, this is just a tip. Okay, it works most of the time. If you see 5 to 7 minute candle, market can give a reversal after 5 candles or after 7 candles. Okay, depending upon whether it is forming, showing you a reversal direction or not. 5 means we are talking about 25 minutes. 7 candle means we are talking about 35 minutes. Okay, Bank Nifty, irrespective of how big the move is, whether it is upside or downside, after 25 to 35 minutes or within that half an hour ka time aap le lo, after half an hour it has to give a retracement, because this is index. Okay, this is not stock. Indexes are made to be range bound, okay, over a period of time, and that is where option seller make money in index. Okay, and big money stocks mein to thoda kam milta hai, index mein the premiums are very, very high. They make money because of this philosophy that indexes are supposed to be range bound. Range bound means 80% of the time. That means in a year, around nine months, you will see indexes being range bound, and 3 months you will see them in a momentum trade. Okay. Now that is on a positional basis, guys. That is option selling strategies. We are not talking about option selling. We are talking about option buying. So in option buying, see this tip which I am giving you. Okay, 5 to 7 candles, market has to give a retracement. See this retracement. See this retracement, and see this retracement. Okay, and you do it in a range bound market also. Friday ka bhi aap dekho. Okay, Friday ka bhi aap dekho. If you see it, let's see from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Up. 1, 2, 3. Let's count this also. 4, 5, 6, 7. Up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Down. Okay. That is what I'm trying to do. This back testing. Don't believe me because I'm telling this. But what I'm saying, yeah, I've given you an example of range bound. I've given you an example of extremely bullish bound. Okay. Irrespective of this also, if you see these numbers ideally, the 5 to 7 candles, which is basically 25 to 35 minutes, it has to give a reaction. Now, can I take reactions in all the trade in all the scenarios? No, it's not that easy. Just looking at my video, you cannot start taking trade. What you need to do is, there are a few things that I said. If you watch my scalping wala video, I have told you how to identify levels, zones. जैसे ये हम लोग जैसे plan करते हैं, we plan our trades. मैंने Friday को बोला था आपको कि यहाँ पे market जाएगा तो मैं sell करूँगा, और gap up अगर हुआ तो मैं sell on rise में रहूँगा, gap down हुआ तो unidirectional positiveness में रहेगा. वो view हम लोग कैसे बनाते हैं? How do we make that kind of view? How do we plan our trades? That is a more complex one, because you need to have a lot of time spent into the stock market, or probably take a training from somebody. Like our students knows that how to identify these kind of stuffs. But here our view is on sell on rise. So if you see, every rise has been sold. Eh? You could see this beauty, right? Now, if you have a view like that, then you have a level. Like you can use any level. Let's use you are using a moving average crossover like this, okay? And you are taking trading. you have your CPS strategy, you have your Camarilla pivot strategy, you have any strategy. There are 10,000 strategies in market. Whatever is suitable to you, you go there. Okay, you use there. Okay, and if it is working for you over a period of time, then you know that market is going to move here. You are confident and market will come down from here, this level, it will go back from this level. Okay, so what I'm not teaching you strategies in this video, I'm teaching you psychology and the rules that will make you successful. Okay, so I'm assuming that you have the tools, right technical analysis and knowledge to identify from where market will make a move. Okay, so let us say you have identified that market will fall from here. Okay, ideally you have taken a PE, right? Now what I'm saying, pay attention. Okay, the tip that I've given you, 5 to 7 candles. If you're an option scalper, okay, I personally, in Bank Nifty and Nifty both, I never stay in market more than 15 minutes if I'm doing option buying, and that too if the trend is in my favor. Okay, if the trend is in not in my favor, I would still stay 15 minutes, but I'll cut my losses and go. Okay, if the trend is in my favor, I'll basically trail stop losses and go. If you're an option buyer, I'm giving you in writing, guys, you cannot capture from this move to this move. If people know I have captured this move, right? I did not capture this move. Then again, I have captured this move and I did not capture this move. Option buyer, you cannot capture entire move of the market. Okay, because the moment you have bought your option from here, let's say market went here, let's say from 100 to it went 200. With this fall, you will see that this 200 premium is coming down to 130. There will be a 70 point reduction in money, right? In premium. And that market anyway will kick you out. So you need to identify your own range. Like for Bank Nifty, I have already given in a couple of my straight dive videos, I try to capture minimum 50 to maximum 150 points. This one, this candle, people, if you are watching my channel, if you are in my discussion group channel, in this candle itself, I have made 61,000. The points that I have captured is 63,000. The points I have captured here is 63. Okay, that's what I said. Scalping, I try to capture minimum 50 points, maximum 150 points. Okay, I have never captured more than probably 300 points in my life. Probably I don't remember capturing like 700 or 800 points, never. Okay, and as an option buyer, market will not let you to capture that unless you say, let's say you are buying from here and you say, okay, I got 70 points profit here. And you have a strong view that market will go up, go up, go up. Okay, you have a strong view that market will go up. You say, I'll just lock my profit at 20 points. And if market comes down, and even if I'm losing 150 points and market cutting my, giving me less profit, then also I'm okay. Only in that case, you can actually make big money. But believe me, those kind of scenarios you will find in a year. Out of 200, 300 plus trading days, you will find only 30 to 40 days. Okay. The rest 200 plus days, you will not find those kind of scenarios at all. That is why it is important to make money on a daily basis rather than making jackpots for just 230 days. Okay. That is why I basically add, that is why I said that I believe in the power of addition. Okay. Right. Anyway. So the point that I was trying to make is ideally never stay more than 15 minutes in Nifty and Bank Nifty. Like for example, like this, 5 minutes, 5 minutes, 5 minutes, 15. Would you cut your profit here? No, because the market is giving you more chances. You trail here and then let market kill you out. Okay. Now, when I'm talking about 15 minutes, I'm talking about these areas. For example, I have taken a, bought a PE here. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Okay, 15 minutes is here. Is the candle looking bearish? Yes, the candle is looking bearish. I will stay. Is the next candle is making red? Yes, I will stay. Stay means I will basically trail stop loss. That means if I bought a P here, if the market is here, I might be getting almost 20, 30 points anyway. So lock your profit to 10 points. Okay, if you see market starts consolidating, immediately lock your profit, whatever less it is. Sometimes I exit even 5 or 7 points in option buying too. My quantities are big, like 1,000 quantities, so I make 5,000, 7,000 rupees. But I exit in 5 and 7 points, to be honest, guys. I every day do not make 150 points, 200 points. Okay. But that 5 point and 7 point is still green. It's not red. That is what is important in option buying. Okay. You can make re-entries again when you want. So let's say here you have just got 7 points, right? Market went up and the 5-7 minute candle funda that I have gave and this candlestick pattern that I have already told you, you might have bought PE here again. 1, 2, 3, 4, done. Okay. Trail your profit. Your market will cut up anyway. That's what I'm saying. Market will option buyer ko na market jyada paisa kamane nahi dega unless moves are big like this. Okay. It is very, very rare to make money. So that is why I follow this. So the timing period, guys, as I told you, the timing you need to keep is 15 minutes. Okay. Time of stay. 15 minutes. And you are good. Believe me, I've just given you three to four rules in the entire video. Okay. And given some tip anyway. If you just follow these things, even if you are making, let's say 500, even if your quantity is big, right? And you are making just 1,000 rupees and 2,000 rupees on one trade, then it is still better because if the market reverses the direction, no, the loss that you will make would probably, the market will give you an incentive for staying more longer. Okay. And then if you're upar jayega, aapko aur loss hota jayega. You will get more losses. You'll get more losses and you'll do for a hope trading. So rather than doing hope trading, exit the market with small profits. Okay. Anyway, those are psychologies. This is what the mantra is. Okay. So be a very good scalper and time of stay is 15 minutes. Okay. In the scalping video, I have already explained you many rules that you guys need to actually go ahead and look at it. The one rule I would tell you without naked eyes, this, see, all this trading now I'm telling you is right now without any indicators. Okay. Just psychology and candlesticks without any indicators. We are going to do trade and timing because option buying, that is what is important. Option buying, the indicators and everything, it might just give you an entry, but exit is very, very important in option buying. Okay. And that is the reason I'm telling you the rules for exiting actually. Okay. So this 15 minutes time period, remember this, make a rule. I will exit. So 5, 10, 15 market consolidating, I will exit. I may re-enter again because option buying may re-entry may you will make money. If you stay longer, you will never make money. Okay. You might make money 1 or 2 days, but the next 8 days you will make losses. Okay. So 50, from my experience in index, Nifty and Bank Nifty, 15 minutes is a good time period, even in impulsive bull or bear run. Okay. Make this rule and don't be greedy. So ye 15 minute ka time apne dimag mein register karne ka hai, theek hai? And the 5-candle, 7-candle principle that I have told you, remember that. Okay. Because market will give, index has to give retracement. Index just cannot fly like 5,000 points. It's not possible. Indexes are not made for that. Okay. So as long as you understand these very, very simple things. Okay. I'm not talking about any rocket science, and trading is all about understanding simple things only. So as long as you're understanding these simple things and you started making continuous money, green money, irrespective of how small it is, you keep on adding them. You will thank me at the end of the month that you have made some money. That then you might have lost money in the previous months, but probably next month onwards, you might make some good money. Okay. The only thing that I have not explained you, I have told you exit. The only thing I have not explained you how to do entries. See, entries are complex. Usi ke liye to hum itna padhte hain, technical analysis karte hain, in trend line banate hain, support resistance banate hain, Fibonacci level banate hain, ye banate hain, wo banate hain, theek hai? To itna kuch jo banate hain, ideally that's for entry. So this video is not for entry. Okay. So uske liye mere aur kuch videos hain that you can watch or you can probably ask me questions. Okay. One more tip I want to give you. before we close this video today, I wanted to make it small and with crisp rules. Okay, I've just given you 4-5 rules. That's it. Whenever market, the 5-minute and 7-candle principle that I have given, one of the things that I have explained in my video also before is ideally the retracement of Fibonacci. Okay, and we are not going to, as I said, we are not going to use any indicators. So it has to be naked. When I'm saying naked, the number that you remember is ideally 50%. Okay, though the rule is actually 61.8, that means you remember the number as 50. 50% is very easy to remember. उसके लिए फिबोनाची का इंडिकेटर लगाने की जरूरत नहीं है, कैलकुलेशन नहीं है. स्विंग लो टू स्विंग आएगा 50%. Okay, that means if you are going to stay in the trend. Okay, I was talking about the 15 minutes wala rule. If you saying, sir, I want to capture bigger moves. Okay. And if you want to stay in the trend, just remember, यहाँ से यहाँ तक अगर मेरा swing high, swing low है, इसका 50% कहाँ पे? यहाँ पे होगा almost. This is like 50%, isn't it? From here to here, the 50% would be around here, isn't it? So if I just make a, just let's see, 50% कहाँ पे होगा? यहाँ पे होगा, ideally, isn't it? Yeah. 50% is around here. So until market is closing below this level, I'm not going to exit. That means in that case, you are telling I am ready to lose this much of profit. That is okay. So for example, let's say I have made 500 points in option here. Okay, this is a big move. Assume that this is a 500 point option. You say I'm ready to lose 300 points, but I want to capture the bigger trend. If you want to do that, that is extremely depending upon your own choice. But me personally would actually, if I'm getting 500 points, I'll capture 500 points straight first. Okay, I will wait for this, and when from the FIBO 50% level, it might go from here, it might go from before also. But if it is returning from this level, I'll make a re-entry again if possible, and if it is at the level, because I am a level based trader. Okay. And if the price action, candlestick price action is telling me to do an entry, I'll capture another point of 300-400 here, which I actually did on that day. If you have seen, क्योंकि मैंने कुछ charts, मैंने कुछ trades अपने दिखाए थे. I have shown it in the channel. I have captured this move, and then I have re-entered again on this move. Captured this both the moves. Okay, because of this level, there was one level here, the reason of entry. Okay. Level, and there are other reasons because of which we made an entry here. Okay, right? So these are the simple rule, guys. Very simple ones, nothing fancy. But if you make it as a rule and trade with this discipline, I'm 100% sure it is going to trade your trading style a little bit. Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you for listening. Good night. Jai Mata Di. Videos agar acha lagta hai to dusre logo ke saath share kijiye. Do share with others if you like it. Okay? And do give a feedback. If the video content is good or not, so that I can improvise in future. Jai Mata Di. Good night.